footballgameplan.com, where football makes sense. I'm Emory Hunt, the czar of the playbook. Bring you our Week 1 Colonial Athletic Association Game of the Week preview between the Villanova Wildcats and the Boston College Eagles. Now let's take a look at some keys to victory for both teams, starting with Villanova.
Villanova was a very good football team last year at the FCS level. They got great play from quarterback John Robertson, who was a redshirt freshman making his first start in college football. And now as a sophomore, they're expecting him to take that next step and grow as a passer. The secondary in that 3-3-5 is inexperienced, especially at the safety position. That's going to be a tough test this week versus Boston College. If they come in and play loose, they have a great chance. You play loose, you play like you've been there before, not too big of a stage, and that could yield positive results this week versus the Eagles. Now let's move over to Boston College in this ball game. And when you look at new head coach Steve Adazio, a former offensive lineman, you instantly want to look at that offensive line of Boston College and see the dramatic improvement that he's going to implement this year. That was a huge detriment last year. Now Chase Reddick could have the time in the pocket to make big plays deep down the field. Defensively, Boston College has to do a better job of getting pressure on a quarterback. Last year, they were only able to come away with 6 sacks on the entire season. That has to improve, especially this week versus a mobile quarterback in John Robertson of Villanova. The X factor in this ball game for Villanova will be the passing game. Last year, quarterback John Robertson was efficient with the football, 14 touchdowns, 7 interceptions, 60% completion percentage. They need him to be a little bit more dynamic throwing the football and be able to hit some big plays deep down the field. That could not only carry them to a victory versus Boston College, but also to an FCS title. The X factor for Boston College, in my opinion, will be running back Andre Williams. Now he's going to be running behind a rebuilt offensive line, a rededication to the running game, so that way they can operate off balance. And if he can get it going early, things will bode well for Boston College moving forward throughout the course of the season. Now here are some coaching points for both teams in this matchup. For Villanova, they have to get their hands on wide receiver Alex Amadon at the line of scrimmage and throughout the course of the play. Don't allow him free release and free reign to run through your secondary. And you have to make a conscious effort for a balanced offensive attack. Allow John Robertson to get into a groove early throwing the football, and that bodes well for you guys later on in the game. In a big battle that has to be won on the defensive side of the football, you look at defensive tackle Antoine Lewis going against center Andy Gaelic. You have to win that battle up front to disrupt what Boston College wants to do offensively. Now for the Eagles in this ball game, you have to get A-gap pressure versus a guy that can move. Robertson is a mobile quarterback. Get that pressure down to A-gap and you can have some success. And get aggressive on the corners until the wide receivers of Villanova can prove they can make plays consistently. And you want to attack the hash and the seam in the passing game. We talked about it earlier, how the Villanova Wildcats in that 3-3-5 are weak at the safety position. So you can attack these guys with Amadon. You also have Coleman, a big body wide receiver, and a very good tight end. Now here are some of the pro prospects that you want to keep an eye on in this matchup. Defensive tackle Antoine Lewis for Villanova, 6'2", 280 pounds, an outstanding run defender that's looking to add pass rushing ability to his repertoire this season. For Boston College, quarterback Chase Reddick will finally put it all together this season and put together a fine campaign now that he has the offensive line. Alex Amadon, outstanding wide receiver that doesn't drop a pass thrown his way. And keep an eye on linebacker Kevin Pierre-Lewis. You know Boston College continues to churn out great linebacker prospects, and he's next in line and should be a fine one this season. Before he dominated opponents at the National Football League level, he was dominating teams at Villanova. This is a guy that was an outstanding defensive tackle, moved to the defensive end where he became a consensus All-American and captured the MVP trophy in the Blue-Gray All-Star Classic. The only Division I program to offer Doug Flutie a scholarship was Boston College, and he repaid these guys back by only becoming the NCAA's all-time leading passer at the time with over 10,000 yards. He won the Heisman Trophy and brought these guys to national prominence with his amazing and exciting play. I like Boston College in this matchup. New coach, new attitude, new direction, and quietly, there's some talent on this roster for Adazio to be successful in year one. Keep an eye on this team in the ACC, but also keep an eye on Villanova as they will be a factor in the FCS National Championship race, but Boston College wins this one at home.